boulder. Fingerpeg mark. Right up the middle of the green. It's certainly not a bad ball. About 18 inches from the block. Now it's about 3 foot from the block. And Chris McDonald's got one touching the block. He tried to hit his own ball. That did knock Chris off, we don't know which. But it didn't work and he's pushed his own wood. Yeah, he has farther out from the block. Well, left that one short, did Chris. One to Chris McDonald. Chris McDonald has bowled the thumbpeg mark. Going to go across the green again, I feel, when he wins this end. That first ball's not 2 foot from the block. What can Gary Wallace do with it? Oh, now then. The crowd has had a hard look. They think it's just run out. How come the referee's being told off? Chris was just a bit on the tight side with that one. He could be counting two. Be counting any in a minute. Oh no. Seems to be asking for measures. He's brought his own. Yes. What a good ball. On to Gary Wallace. He's going out, four across. This looks like Gary's ball the thumbpeg mark, deep into the corner. Try the bowling knot. He's led with the wood. About a foot from the, about a yard from the block. Chris McDonald's just bowled one in, and he's a foot from the block. Excellent ball. And this ball of Gary Wallace's still. As if it can, it's a cracker. Oh, it's a good ball. A round of applause from the audience, and well deserved. McDonald, and I feel we're in for a real cracking final between these two bowlers. And Gary Wallace is bowling on the corner mark that Ian Davis, ball Chris on.
And it's a good lead, it's about 2 foot past the block. The ground are condemning this one as short.
It's at least 2 yards short, I think that Chris will correct with his next ball though.
This ball of Gary's looks to be tight.
Dead on land. Wish I could ball them as tight as that.
What can Chris do with this one? Well, he's trying. Oh, good effort.
Saving. Certainly it's a tight final. To see some corner bowling from Gary. Finger peg, he's bowled it back.
Leaping into the corner.
Well, somebody said ball another one. And that's an excellent ball. And a foot short of the block.
Give Chris something to bowl at.
And Chris is about 4 foot through. Can Gary Wallace put the pressure on and get another one in there? Well, he's having a look.
Yeah, the two good balls for Gary Wallace.
Now then, what's it? Oh, Chris, just running at the back of that short ball of Gary's. Big one, he still might be two. No. Back to Gary Wallace. Getting back across the green, right over the crown, thumb peg. Slight change of land this time, he's farther over. And he's about a yard from the block. He's nearly a dead length.
There's too much room.
Go out with a miss. And the referee confirms it's gone out. And that's a cracking ball for Gary Wallace.
Now the same as a good ball coming up.
He weren't far wrong, but it just didn't do enough. The game is now 8-4. The favour of Gary. And he's bowled another.
Well,
20 yards through. There's a better ball coming in. Good ball from Chris McDonald there. About 2 foot short of the block. Looks like Gary Wallace is about 3 foot through. Can Gary Wallace adjust? Take anything out. In fact, long way through with a miss. Now can this ball of Chris's get another? No, we can. Good ball. Good balls. McDonald's changed the land, he's now gone thumb peg. He's split the green again. Each time he's bowled across here, Gary Wallace has beat him. He's about, it's a dead length to the jack, but he's about a yard away. Ball to Gary Wallace, can he get there? Ah, he's short. Sun's now shining brilliantly for the final. Oh, there's a better ball there from Chris McDonald. Another dead length ball. Still room. This wood going to do short again. Game is now 8 across. Chris McDonald is where he won the cup. On the mark he won the cup. Finger peg. Back across the green towards the ball, you know. Well, that's a fair lead from Chris. It's about a yard short. It's right on the road. Can Gary Wallace get past it? Wallace is short. She needs to hit the pace of the screen up a bit better. Seems as though he's just lost his length for a few ends. Chris said miss it, but it didn't. But he's right in the road with two woods. Gary Wallace looks farther this time. Stop. Might be a good stop. One to Gary Wallace, a good ball. You can see from the scoreboard in the background, it's a very close game. Gary's changed tactics, small round peg. It's likely to be about 23 yards, not much more. And the 9-inch ball on the front. Well, I don't think Chris can get back from there, can he? He's having a good go. Pegging balls and with Chris McDonald. Oh, Gary Wallace has put one in here. Oh, good ball in Gary. Another round of applause that does. Chris is going to have a strike. stays on. Can't see from the crowd. Somebody said, never mind, Gary, lads, who think he's gone off. Change of land, I think he's thinks he'll roll them short ones. Chris will just knock them off. He's gone into the corner again, finger peg. He's gone about 4 foot through. Chris deal with this bowl. Must be on a good road. Oh, a good bowl. It's dropped about 6 or 9 inches behind the block. Yeah, they've always been on the loop with this one. Oh, that fellow there. Another round of applause from the crowd. Chris can't just pick it up. Another one to Gary Wallace, going 10-8. This looks like a thumb peg mark. Back down towards the middle of the green. Your camera position. Stamping at it is Gary. Quite rightly so. Stopped about a yard and a half short. There's one here that isn't going to stop a yard and a half short. An excellent ball. Well, now what a ball. It was an excellent ball from Chris McDonald, but that was a cracker from Gary Wallace. What can Chris do now? Can he disturb the end? No. One more to Gary Wallace. The game is now 11-8. Well, Gary's gone back into the corner, finger peg. Where did he just come from? Somebody's just shouted, good ball, Gary lad, and it certainly is a good ball. Chris McDonald's urging this wood on. It's just died, about a yard and a half short. Might be 2 yards. The camera angle's deceiving. Gary Wallace got another one in there. The pressure on. He's gone tight. Looks like he's only one. Good effort, even if it has, if it hasn't won. It has won. A good ball there from Chris McDonald.
Luke from our position to a run out, but it's a bad angle.
Change of tactics. It's a finger peg mark on the far side of the green. Gary Wallace isn't. Looks to be around a foot from the block. Chris tightened up on this ball. Might have gone through the gap. Crowd say Gary Wallace is on. Can he get two? Certainly can. Not one. Gary's coming back down the green towards the camera position. The finger peg mark. It was this area of the green when he. Donald too far out. Yeah. Well, Gary, you need to stamp it. It's counting. Chris McDonald looks too far out again to me. The game is now 14-9. Seems to be controlling this game and playing very well, as Gary Wallace. Like a thumb peg mark up towards the corner again. He's abandoned those short marks due to what just into the end. He soon smacked them up. Ball looks to be a yard short. Well, the crowd are condemning it as tight. Nice as well as short. You've got to get another one in there. Put the pressure on. Better than his first. No, it isn't. Just running behind his first. But his right's unrolled. Will we see a strike? I thought we would, and the block's gone. If you go and hit him. Hit him like that. Nearly broke the block. He's a big lad, is Chris, and he certainly smacked that. Look at the ball went very much from the straight line, it was going that quick. He's back, and the mark is persisting with it, and he's bowled another. Not a lot
wrong with that, Gary?
There's a good ball coming in here. That's a cracking ball. That's gone in. There's another ball coming here, I know. Somebody said, what about this? Oh. Oh, that's worthy of a close-up, that is. Somebody's got to get another. I'm not sure how you get another. I wouldn't like to disturb that end. Will he come the other peg? He will. He's bowling up. It's a very important end, that one, for Chris. No. 10-4. He's gone back in the corner, but he's gone finger peg this time. Gary's been bowling it some peg. You see, he's urging the ball on, and he couldn't urge it on enough. There's a better ball going in from Gary Wallace here. Oh, that's a real one, that is, as they say. Think that Chris McDonald will get to that. Now that's having a look. Oh, what a good ball. You want a quick look at that end if you can. One touching and one a few inches away. Oh, Gary's not short. He's going to hit something. Oof. Held out with the speed. The game is now 11-14. This is an excellent final. Very close ball. The crowd can't really ask for any more. Even the sun's out, shining. Just bowled him on the full corner mark, thumb peg. Well, I think it needs to run a touch. I just died about a yard and a half of the block. Gary's short. He's about 2 yards short. Lovely road. Just needed that bit more of it. Oh, can Chris get that other yard in it? He's left it for me, but just sneaked in for another. A lot of room. Aye, aye, somebody's saying in the crowd again. Oh. Bit of miss, it's a certain winner. going back, finger peg. Get deep into the corner. Don't know how big these corners are, but they look to be 55 yards. Well, there's not a lot wrong with that. It looks to be about 2 foot past the block. 80 inches. Gary Wallace needs to run a bit. Lovely road, a couple of yards short. Chris McDonald will get another. Pressure's on. Oh, good balls, Chris. Well, can Gary put another yard or two in that ball? He's having a look. Oh, he missed. Gone through. And for the first time in this match, I can recall, Chris McDonald is in front at 15-14. It's a very important time to go in front. Important time any time. Back again. Finger peg again. It's an extra yard into the corner. Does Chris like this one? He's not following it. Go on. Well, that's an excellent ball there from Chris. And a foot from the block. Gary needs to get back into this game now. And he's having a good look. Oh, just a yard short. Good effort. Well, Chris was running that one in. Just pick the block up, he's run out. The only one that took the block behind his own ball, making it difficult for Gary Wallace to get it. Gary Wallace to get it. Good effort. Good effort from Gary. McDonald has been favourite throughout this competition to win it. And it looks like he's now coming good. Incidentally, he's an ironmonger, not as we had him last season in the Bassmasters when he won that as a butcher. He did put us right and tell us he was an ironmonger. Well, that's a real one there, alright. He really is giving Gary something to do on these clubs. To peg a bit for me. Good effort. Somebody's just shouted, kick it. Thank you. sure what the referee was signalling then. I think it was one. On to Chris MacDonald. Well, he turned over. What a good. Now then, I don't know who's on, but Gary Wallace turned that wood over. And it was hard luck. It was a good effort, that was. He just wanted that block a bit cleaner. ...17-14 now, Chris MacDonald. Has he got this game? He's certainly looking favourite. Said if you give first Gary a chance. Four football and not that big. Well, they're all saying what a good ball it is and what a good ball it is. Dead length ball, about a foot from the block. What's Chris saying with this one? And kick it, and it's still a yard short. It's a yard through and a yard short from Chris MacDonald. Can Gary get another one? Well, he's bowled up for another. Made him for me. Better than his first. The game is now 16-17. This really is a good final. It's a finger peg mark he's going to play on. He's going up, split the green again. Just over the crown. Can Gary put the lead up that he needs? Well, the crowd have said good ball, and it is a good ball. There's one going up here. It's never bad. An excellent ball there from one deserve a round of applause from the crowd. Well, he's got the trip as Gary. And the referee has confirmed to Chris MacDonald that he's on. Can he get another? Because if he can, no, only one. It's 18. Chris has bowled him some peg. Back into the corner. And he's bowled the block off. First time I've seen the block go off all afternoon. Well, they seem to be having a good laugh out there. I didn't think the block would be going back to that place. Gary's bowled it finger peg. Just short of the corner. And it looks like it's just over a mark. And as the crowd said, it's a reeler. A good ball from Chris McDonald there. There's one there having a look. And just slipping past. Can't tell from here whether Chris is lying one or two. Only one, as you can see. The miss is flying, and he certainly was. He had to bowl up to disturb the end. The game is now 19-16. Behind in his semi before 18-13 and won it 21-20. Well, Chris McDonald has bowled finger peg into the corner under the camera position. And he looks to be nicely paced. Just slipping through a yard. Well, this seems to be better paced. An excellent ball there, about 6 inches from the block. Has Chris McDonald left it? Good effort. Gary Wallace get two here. He's having a go. Just died short. Good road. 17-19. This is certainly worthy of a final. The standard of the bowling. Finger peg mark again, just below the crown of the green, towards the sponsor's side. McDonald beat him before going up this part of the green, but he's got something to bowl at now. That ball, it touched the block and it's just fallen over, and it's about 4 inches from the block. Chris McDonald looks to be too fast to me. He had to disturb the end if it was possible. He just stuck it out too far. Can Gary Wallace get another? He's on a lovely road. Oh, excellent bowling, but I feel that he's now widened the block, widened the head. Can't see Chris McDonald really missing it. But if he gets the block with this wood. Ooh. I think Gary Wallace just waved his arms in the air then. Just tapped Chris on the shoulder, a friendly gesture. Gary knew. Now 19 across. Both players can go out at this end. really has been a fabulous final. Gary's gone right down the middle of the green and a thumb peg back. He's about 18 inches from the block and it even fell over the right way. And Chris MacDonald. It's gone too tight for me. Has it gone in? I think it might have gone in. Freddie Hume's just telling the referee off. And the referee thinks that he's giving him here, right? Oh, Gary Wallace is short. Now then. Chris MacDonald is on. If he can get the other one he needs, it's game, shot and match. Oh! Oh, Chris. You see him throwing the mat up. It was a hell of a ball with a miss. Certainly a winner. Well, you can see from the antics of Gary Wallace, he's giving himself three. Finger peg mark back into the top corner. Can he get into the good lead and get the one he wants? Well, that's a good ball when you only want one. That last end, it's Chris MacDonald knocked that ball in. Could that cost him the title? Well, Gary Wallace is standing down at this bottom end here, smiling, chatting to the crowd. Can you get yourself another one in there? In Chris's road. Oh, well. Shall it? I was that busy watching it. I forgot about the camera. The block is right in amongst those three woods. And I think it needs to run. To save the title. Now, as you can see, Gary Wallace is the Klondike champion at 21-19. It's all in all bowling videos. The organisers now thanking all the people, quite rightly so. Should thank the workers.
All our scorers in the hut. We must have done about 30 hours each between them over 9 weeks. It's a hell of a job. But fortunately, we've got a good club, we've got plenty of people willing to help, and it makes everything go smoothly. As a last thank you, I just want to ask one gentleman to come out here. Oh, sorry, I forgot to thank John for doing all his work selling raffle tickets. Just one gentleman I want out here, our club president, Ken Fallow.
I thought his name was John, it's Ken. Sorry, Ken.
Now, Ken is one of these quiet guys who hides. You don't see what he does. He doesn't say a lot. He's not very good at talking. But he's club president, he's chairman of the board, and he's the most hard-working man I've ever come across. We've been very lucky at this club to have working presidents. It's fair to say, and I hope the others don't mind, that I've never seen anybody work as hard as Ken. And I'd like to thank him very much. Right, now, down to presentation of the prizes. We're fortunate to have a representative from our sponsor, Thwaites Brewery, Mr. John Birchall. Would you like to come this way, John? We'll sort it out. Thank you.
John Birchall, as you heard, brewery representative, did do the honours.
Now, as you know, there were 16 bowlers started today. That's out to an entry of 256. Now, the losers in the first round today have already received their prizes, but I would remind you that they have bowled tremendously well to get here today. Albeit to lose in the first game, but they deserve a round of applause. Thank you. So we'll move on to the prizes for the second round losers today. As I've said, all have bowled tremendously well. Can we start off with Stan Grimshaw?
Signing off.